Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a tutorial today on how to throw a teapot. This teapot's going to be pretty intense. It is going to have some extreme angles, and so you have to take a different method with three different sections. And let's get started. So you can see here that I'm starting to throw a bowl right away. This bowl is just pretty simple. It's small, but the biggest thing you're gonna have to make sure that you do is measure the outside with a caliper. This is going to help you make another section that is the same width so you can join them together later. So with the other section, I'm gonna make this pretty much flat. I really want this angle to be really extreme, and to do that, I'm gonna make this flat, and when I'm gonna let these dry out overnight, and when these dry out, it's going to help me give both of these strength so that they don't collapse on the inside, because you'll see in a little bit how they would. So when joining them together, I'm gonna slip and score both of these together and kind of push them in, and then I'm just gonna start going around with clay and filling in those little cracks so that you can create a nice joint edge there, kind of like you would with a handle or a spout or whatever it may be. Pretty simple process, and going from there, you can smooth these down really well and create a really nice bond. Next, I'm just gonna be throwing like I'm throwing a spout. If you've never thrown a spout, this is gonna be new to you, and this teapot might be pretty difficult, but it's gonna be just a very, very thin cylinder. This is actually going to go on top of that flat section to create another kind of tight angle. Because with this sectional thing, you can create almost any angle you want, so long as they're dry enough. And it creates really cool designs and really cool pieces just by what you're able to create, since you're able to combine things instead of throwing them all at once. After throwing that tall cylinder, I need to cut out a hole for a place for it. You can see I've done some work on the body as well, just kind of cleaning it up after I attach the two together. So I'm going to take those apart, I'm going to slip and score them, and I am going to place a nice layer of slip. These are pretty dry, so I need to make sure they come join pretty well. And I'm just gonna start making sure that I can get in there with a tool, put it down there so you can smooth out that inside so they join together, and I'd put a little strip of clay on the outside as well to help them join. So next I'm actually going to throw the spout. This is actually gonna be even thinner than the other piece, which is gonna be kind of difficult if you've never done a thin one. The trick with spouts is making sure that the bottom is gonna be wider than the top. This is gonna create pressure for the water to come out, and so it just doesn't dribble out and go down. Also nice sharp edges at the top. So I'm gonna make my base pretty wide, and I'm just gonna kind of push in a lot while I'm throwing. A trick to throw tall and thin is eventually you can get it to where you can kind of just push in with your outside fingers when you can no longer reach the bottom like I'm doing here, and pull it up that way too, and then you can kind of throw the top because it's going to be a bit thicker. So you can see that here my spout is actually curved. I'm going to talk about that for the first little bit here. To curve it, all you're going to do is kind of slowly with your hands just kind of nudge it that way. Make sure your hands are wet so that you don't create cracks. Make sure you don't pinch it when you're doing this, because pinching it will close off a section and it won't allow you to pour water out. But now with attaching the handle, I'm going to attach a handle in kind of a different way, in a different spot than most handles would be, because I kind of have these cool angles, and I'm going to make it flush with that outside of the body. So that it creates a nice smooth angle, and I can smooth that down later so it looks like almost they're one and coming off of each other. And this is just a super easy process to do. Handles are very simple. If you're making teapots, you've probably made a bunch of them. Just slip and score and attach and clean it up a little bit, and you're gonna be looking really nice. Finally, I'm going to throw a top shape for the top of the cylinder, the small cylinder I have on top of my piece. I'm going to create this at a strict angle. I'm going to clean it up. The biggest thing that I had troubles with here, and what I typically do, is on that bottom it's going to be pretty hard to clean up, so try to get some of the clay off and get it started at that angle. But what I eventually do is just kind of pinch it into the shape that I want it, going around in a circle, so I can get it down deep in there. And you can kind of push it and nudge it, since the clay is pretty firm, down. And this will help you create your top. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and let me know if you have questions.